The efforts of the U.S. Justice Department to recover over $12.5 million of U.S. assets of alleged pork barrel scam mastermind Janet Lim Napoles is no small feat, and good governance advocate Ted Laguatan says other public officials should beware.
It will give a warning also to a lot of corrupt officials in the Philippines, as well as other countries, that the U.S. is not a hiding place for their loot.
Napoles' lawyers may attempt to block the forfeiture, but Laguatan believes in the evidence against her. Lawmakers allegedly involved in the pork barrel scam, Juan Ponce Enrile, Jingoy Estrada, and Bong Revilla, are in detention for graft and plunder charges. But Laguatan believes the scam is bigger and wider.
There's a very high probability that they will be convicted. But of course, elections is just around the corner. The reality of politics is if these cases are not completed by the time the next election comes and the allies of these accused get elected, these cases can be dropped.
But even if the PDAF scandal has yet to be resolved, former Senator Ping Lacson claims the Aquino government and lawmakers are back to their old pork barrel tricks. Lacson says there are over 400 billion pesos in lump sum funds in the 2015 national budget, which lawmakers can spend at their own discretion, even if the Supreme Court has declared this unconstitutional.
Anong implication pag napakalaki ng lump sum? Di ba napakalaki ng discretion? Because ang lump sum, discretionary funds yan eh. So kung may discretion, ibig sabihin yung temptation to commit corruption is much greater.
And as election season approaches and candidates are in need of campaign funds, observers are saying these conditions may be rife for massive corruption.
As the U.S. moves to recover the Napoles assets, the cases of those involved in the PDAF scandal are dragging on in the Philippines. And as political observers say, their fate may change depending on the outcome of the upcoming elections. Paul Hanson, ABS-CBN News, San Mateo.